help them get what they need and send them off on their way. So the talentless ones, you know, the most investing side plots, they apparently next go to a tarot card reading where a fortune teller accurately explains what's going on, but it's so loony that they don't believe her. Classic. Another joke you probably missed if you were three like me. All suited up, MJ is ready. Also, it's clearly the start of the editor's green screen attempts for the film, as his backlight feathering above his head animates a little bit too much for this moving shot. Also, Stan now appears down in the world. Another scene that completely went over my head is all of basketball being cancelled this season. I guess it's just not very interesting and very, very minor of a point. So now here we are, 51 minutes in, and the big match can finally begin. The last third of the movie. The preparation montage with each character here is still really, really good. And hey, even Danny DeVito showed up. And yes, Tumblr was right. The Martian is the referee because he's neutral. He's a Looney Tune and an alien. You know, cool, cool details. At this point, clearly it's the big moment of the film, but it's also pretty basic in terms of what actually happens. It's kind of your standard high-stakes basketball game, you know? The first round goes badly, the Monstars are decimating, but occasionally the Looney Tunes do score. Clearly there's an inkling of hope there, but something needs to be done. Halftime. Mr. Swaghammer confronts the Monstars for no real reason and Stan spies on them. He learns of the stealing talent trick the Nerdlucks used and gets immediately sniffed out by the others. Over to the Tunes and they feel defeated, naturally. Stan finally arrives, beaten up and with that info.
Yes.
When Bugs introduces Michael's secret stuff, entirely fictitious hope that hypes everybody up. This gun joke is literally the highlight of the movie, and it's so weirdly chucked in too. It's just a 5-second moment. Not even the music keeps going or anything. Like, it's a literal vine-paced joke. Weird. It's at this point that the Tunes finally make their mark in the game. Don't ask about the rules of the game. Anything goes, apparently. This is where the writers can really spread the ideas of how loony a basketball game could get. And obviously, it's pretty entertaining for the kids and for the whole family. There's all sorts of character cameos and fan service to enjoy, and the Tunes manage to catch right up. Also, Tweety Bird goes crazy. With things looking up for the Tunes, Swaghammer calls a timeout, as he now wants MJ instead of all of the Looney Tunes. And this guy's thing is all about slavery and spreading suffering onto his workers, which is admittedly kind of dark, but somehow it doesn't feel too badly dramatic considering how it's laid out. It's just generic bad guy plans. And thankfully, it doesn't have too much of a dark undertone, which it definitely could have explored if it really wanted to. MJ makes an agreement to be taken in if he loses, but otherwise, they continue. And in this next bout, the Monstars crush them, using any physical tricks they can think of. The rules of the game have very much gone off the rails.